Hello, folks, and welcome to episode 69 of The Organist Entertains from here at Bellshill Central Parish Church. We have already begun tonight with a wonderful hymn of praise. All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing, Alleluia, Alleluia. And this is a request from my mum, Mary Matthew. The tune is Last Uns Erfruen, and that is from music from the Gestrike Kirchensange from Cologne in 1623, arranged in our hymnal by Rafe Vaughan Williams. The words themselves are from St. Francis of Assisi, translated by William Henry Draper. Now, this particular hymn, tune more than words perhaps, conjures up humorous thoughts for my mum. When I'm sitting here at the organ bench with the choir behind me on a pre-COVID Sunday morning, if this was a hymn of choice, my mum would be in stitches. Now, that is because it featured in an episode of Mr. Bean 20, 30 years ago. There is Mr. Bean, played by Rowan Atkinson, at church, sitting next to a man dressed up in a shirt, tie, suit, etc., I think played by Richard Brier. And the hymn is All Creatures of Our God and King. Now, looking at the music, I will come to the harmony part which makes this humorous. The Alleluia, Alleluia at the end has three Alleluias preceded by two O Praise hymns. And Mr. Bean proceeded to go, Oh, praise him, oh, praise him, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Which we all know is not the correct way to finish. The Alleluias finish, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. And he never got it right. Or perhaps he did when he got to the last verse. So, Mum, you will have laughed all the way through All Creatures of Our God and King as you remember Mr. Bean singing at church. Now, moving on, our second hymn tonight is Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. The hymn has been requested by Mary Matthew. It is to the tune of Nicaea, music by John Dykes, and the words themselves are by Reginald Heber. Now, I know that this is a favourite of Mum's, however, it may be because it featured in our online service on the 1st of August that made it spring to her mind. So now we have Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. And for the harmony singers, I've not ventured into the famous last verses yet.
Thank you.
Our next choice tonight, our third in tonight's list, is requested by Elspeth Dornan. Elspeth is a choir member here at Bellshill Central, and Elspeth is taking part in this coming week's online service by reading the Bible reading. When I asked Elspeth to do that, because I put together our online services, she said to me, "So does that mean we're singing, Sing of the Lord's Goodness?" To which I said, I hadn't thought about the hymns yet for our online service on Sunday, but Sing of the Lord's Goodness seemed a good choice. She then went on to say, "Could I have it in this week's Organist Entertains?" "Of course," says I. Sing of the Lord's Goodness has music and words by Ernest Sands. It tells us to come and sing of the Lord's goodness and raise our melodies of praise and give thanks, that we should praise him with our music, and worship him and bless his name. So Elspeth, there couldn't be a better choice to have on an Organist Entertains. So here we have, which I know is one of your favourite hymns, Sing of the Lord's Goodness, Father of All Mercy, a jaunty, joyful and exuberant hymn. Moving to the Psalms, we have our next choice. The hymn has been requested by our friend in Tweedbank, Sheila Miller. It's a version of Psalm 139. You are before me, God, you are behind. Written by Ian Robertson Pitt Watson and set to the tune of Sursum Corda by Alfred Morton Smith. We've had this hymn chosen before, I think by one of the McLeods from Craig Lockhart Church in Edinburgh, where they had a connection with the writer of Ian Robertson, Pitt Watson. And I think the story goes that Ian McLeod was on the terraces at Pittodrie in Aberdeen, along with Ian Robertson, Pitt Watson. If I haven't got that quite right, Ian, do let me know and I'll try and remember and correct it. However, Sheila loves all the Psalms and particularly loves the words and meaning behind Psalm 139. You are before me, God, you are behind. Moving on to our next hymn request, which is hymn number 5 in tonight's list. It's been requested by our friend in Hamilton, Elspeth McGregor. It's the hymn King of Kings, Majesty, written by Jared Cooper. Now, normally, we sing this hymn in church with an extra chorus and an extra little coda at the end. However, the words also lend themselves to being a shade more reflective. King of Kings, Majesty, God of Heaven living in me, gentle Saviour, closest friend, strong Deliverer, beginning and end, all within me falls at your throne. So Elspeth, I know that this hymn will have a lot of meaning for your own personal faith. So thank you for choosing such a wonderfully uplifting hymn, King of Kings, Majesty. Elspeth's next hymn choice could not be more different to her last one. It's the hymn which resounds in churches across the world on Easter Sunday. Now, people are probably guessing, well, it's only going to be one of two. It's either going to be Jesus Christ is risen today, Alleluia, or Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son. It's the second one. Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son, by Edmund Budrie, translated by Richard Hoyle. Of course, it's set to that wonderful tune by George Frederick Handel, Maccabeus, from his oratorio, Judas Maccabeus, of 1746. So, Elspeth, this is another hymn which means rather a lot to you, we know. However, it's a hymn which lots of people enjoy, love, and just sums up that whole feeling of Easter Sunday as we celebrate the glorious resurrection. So, Elspeth and everyone else, Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son, endless is the victory, Thou o'er death hast won.
Thank you.
Well, folks, we have now reached our seventh hymn choice of the night, and it's the first of two from the Reverend Tony Newnham. Tony describes his first choice as being very obscure. Around 20 years ago, he was playing for weddings and funerals at some of the local Anglican churches in Bradford, I believe. The rector of Radwinter in Essex was a very high Anglican church. Phoned him one day to see if he would come a little bit further afield and play for the funeral of a meteorologist. Now, in those days of not having the internet so much, there was quite a problem in finding the hymn, The Roseate Hues of Early Dawn, which had, of course, been requested. Thankfully, the rector of Radwinter in Essex found a copy. Now, the hymn is set to a tune which we all know, Elicum, which is more often sung to Hosanna, loud Hosanna, for Palm Sunday. The words of the roseate hues of early dawn, the brightness of the day, are written by Cecil F. Alexander in 1853. So thank you, Tony, for picking this hymn and letting us see words which we probably haven't seen before and in all likelihood are not probably going to see ever again. The Roseate Hues of Early Dawn, words by Cecil F. Alexander. Tony's next choice is a hymn which some of us may not know. It's the hymn, Lest I Forget Gethsemane, sometimes appearing under the title of Lead Me to Calvary. It is a hymn which he often uses for communion if he is playing at Wolston Baptist Church. Lead Me to Calvary is written by Jeannie Evelyn Hussey in 1921. The refrain lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me, lead me to Calvary. It's a wonderfully meaningful hymn, which I'm sure everyone will enjoy hearing and seeing the words. So thank you, Tony, for requesting your hymn, Lest I Forget Gethsemane, or Lead Me to Calvary. Well, it wouldn't be The Organist Entertains if we didn't visit the household of the Andersons in South Africa. This week, we have a request from Thelma and a request from Ed. First of all, Thelma's hymn choice is Love Lifted Me, with the starting verse of I was sinking deep in sin, sinking to rise no more, overwhelmed by guilt within mercy I did implore. Then the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. Christ my saviour lifted me, now safe I am. Words are by James Rowe and the music is by Howard Smith. It's a hymn which you will find yourself swaying to. It's got a lovely lilt to it as we go through, then with the chorus, Love Lifted Me. So thank you, Thelma, for your hymn choice this week, the first from the Anderson household, Love lifted me. Staying with the Anderson household, we have our next request, and that would be our 10th hymn of the night. It's the hymn, "The Sands of Time Are Sinking," set to the tune of Rutherford, and this is Ed's hymn choice tonight. The melody is adapted in Rimbaud's Hymns for Divine Worship of 1867. And the words are by Anne Ross Cousin, who died in 1906. The hymn is full of words to help our personal faith and devotion. It talks about us wrestling a storm as we travel towards heaven, buffeted by the wind and the tide. However, we are kept safe, and that is the core of our faith, isn't it? That we are kept safe by God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. The sands of time are sinking. Ed's Hymn Choice Tonight in episode 69. Tonight, we only have one piece of organ music to fill in some time between some of our hymn requests. The piece of music which I have chosen tonight is a much-loved song. It's a very familiar piece of music, and it was made famous by being in the film The Mission. It uses our quite lovely oboe stop. It is, of course, the piece of music called Gabriel's Oboe. Now, some people ask, why is it called Gabriel's Oboe? It is the main theme from the film The Mission, and it refers to a scene where Father Gabriel, played by the actor Irons, travels to Equazi Falls and climbs to the top and plays his oboe. It's a delightfully haunting melody. It's a delightfully beautiful melody. And I do hope that it brings a little stillness and calmness to the proceedings of episode 69. Before we go into our next set of hymns. I know that for two viewers, it's going to mean such a such a lot to and bring back such wonderful memories. It was played as the second voluntary during the signing of the marriage schedule of Hugh and Riris back in April. So enjoy reminiscing about your special day here in church. We now have Gabriel's Oboe. Moving on, we have two requests from Bellshill Central member and choir singer Sheena McEwen. The first hymn choice for Sheena tonight is that wonderful psalm, Psalm 100. All people that on earth do dwell, sing to the Lord a joyful song, set to the tune of Old Hundredth. Now, part singers, that book over my shoulder has stayed silent so far. However, it comes out to play for the last verse of All People That on Earth Do Dwell, Sheena McEwen's first choice tonight. Enjoy singing praises to God, All People That on Earth Do Dwell.
Thank you.
Sheena's second hymn choice tonight keeps with the Psalms and the paraphrases. This time, a paraphrase from the Scottish paraphrases of 1781, based on words from Genesis 28, verses 20 to 22. Paraphrase 2. This hymn, I know, is a firm favourite of Alexa Walker. So, Sheena, you are in good company of favourite hymns. O God of Bethel, by whose hand thy people still are fed. It's to the tune Salzburg, with the melody written by Johann Michael Haydn. He died in 1806, and our hymnal tells us that this melody was adapted for congregational singing. O God of Bethel, by whose hand thy people still are fed. Now, it's been a while since we've heard from Andrew McLeod, and we have two hymn choices from Andrew tonight, setting us up in our final section of episode 69. It's the hymn, Let the Flame Burn Brighter, We'll Walk the Land, words and music by Graham Kendrick. The hymnal tells us that it should be played rhythmically, with the words, we'll walk the land with hearts and fire, and every step will be a prayer. Hope is rising, new day dawning, sound of singing fills the air. Now, churches across the land are beginning to see our restrictions coming to an end. And whilst Bellshill Central is not yet open and we are making plans to do that, our plans include being able to sing. So Andrew, thank you for your first hymn choice tonight, Graham Kendrick's We'll Walk the Land. Andrew's second hymn choice tonight keeps us in mission praise. The hymn itself is found in other hymnals. However, Andrew has made a specific request for the tune. The hymn is Christ Triumphant, Ever Reigning, Saviour, Master, King. More commonly sang to the tune of Guiding Power. Andrew has requested, though, the tune Christ Triumphant. The words are by Michael Saward, and this music is written by Michael Bowen. It's got a walking bass line, and you will hear that as we go through the chorus. It's called a walking bass line because it literally does give the effect of walking, moving step by step. So for those people who love this hymn, here is another tune. To Christ Triumphant, Ever Reigning, Saviour, Master, King. In our final set, we have the hymn, One More Step Along the World I Go, by Sidney Bertram Carter. We'd one of his hymns last week, I Danced in the Morning, The Lord of the Dance, and this hymn, like The Lord of the Dance, is a hymn which I know many people will have sung at school assemblies, Sunday school services, and services which involve young people. In recent time, I've also had it requested for a wedding. It's a hymn which talks about the journey of life, the good and the bad, the quiet and the rough, and how we should praise and celebrate God. The penultimate verse from memory talks about travelling through the bad and good and the world being rough. However, it then tells us to leap and sing in all that we do, because God in Jesus is travelling along with us. The hymn is the choice of choir singer, church member and elder, Anne Guy. Anne loves this hymn, and it was reminded to her just how much she loves it, because we had a version of it during online worship last weekend. It's happy, it's jaunty, and it's joyful. And that is how Anne thinks church should be, that we should be full of praise, full of noise, and singing our hearts out in praise and worship of God. So Anne, I hope that you're singing up at home as we have one more step along the world I go. Now we are in the last portion, and it's two hymns selected by myself. The first is a short hymn, a quiet hymn, and a hymn meant to help us in our devotional time. It's the hymn by Bob Kilpatrick, "In My Life, Lord, Be Glorified." The hymn was brought to my attention the other Sunday when I was helping out at St. Margaret's Parish Church in Muirhouse. And they don't have an organ, but they have a digital piano. And one of their last musicians, Neil Kennedy, hello Neil, because I know you sometimes tune in to these videos. When he left and moved to Arran, he left some songs recorded on the memory bank of the digital piano. Most of the hymns were known to the good folks at St. Margaret's. However, there was one or two that they were having a little bit of difficulty placing so that they could use them in their services. One of them was this hymn. So Neil, you've played it on the digital piano, but they didn't know the hymn, so they've not been able to use it yet. So before flying off to Cross Hill on Sunday, I was able to listen to a couple of the hymns and identify them for them. It's a hymn they hadn't heard for quite some time, and they're going to look forward singing in church now they're able to do so. However, it's a softer and gentler hymn, and I thought before we launch into the final hymn choice, it might be a good idea to draw ourselves back, still ourselves, you could say, and listen to the music and words by Bob Kilpatrick. In my life, Lord, be glorified. Our final hymn choice tonight is the hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah, Pilgrim Through This Barren Land. Words by William Williams, I think referred to as the Sweet Singer of Wales, translated by Peter Williams. The tune, Cwm Rhondda, is named after the famous Rhondda Valley, and is music by John Hughes of Pontypridd. Now, I once upon a time attempted to say the Welsh title to this hymn, and it went down like a lead balloon. So I'm not going to try it again. However, this is a hymn which we all love singing. It's a hymn which generally features every time we have a big hymn sing at Bellshill Central Parish Church, and it's a hymn which featured on the praise list at Cross Hill and St Margaret's Parish Churches on Sunday, where I was playing for Sandra Campbell. Now, part singers, yes. The 400 Last Verses hymn book comes out to play on our last hymn tonight, as we enjoy singing, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah, Pilgrim Through This Barren Land, to the tune of Cwm Rhondda. Sing well. Well, folks, we have reached the end of episode 69, and I do hope that it has lived up to your expectations. Next week is episode 70. Oh no, another decade of The Organist entertains. Episode 69 has had lots of your hymns, songs and requests, and it has just shown yet again the breadth and depth of our sung worship songs, from old psalms and paraphrases right up to the more recent hymns, which we know and love and cherish just the same. If you would like to donate to Bellshill Central Parish Church, you can do with the link that's down there below. It's a safe and secure link provided by the Church of Scotland, and it's as I say, all safe and secure. And if you are a UK taxpayer, then you can add a little bit more to the donation by simply ticking a box, because then the Church of Scotland and the good HMRC all do the rest of the work, and we get an extra 20 or 25p in the pound. Send your requests to me for episode 70 and the following episodes that will come. There is an email address which you can use, and it's organist@bellshillcentral.church. A dedicated email address so that you can send your hymn choices directly to me. I do hope that you've enjoyed tonight's episode, that you have enjoyed everyone's hymn choices. The organ is still sounding pretty good, considering it's about 9-10 months since she was last tuned. With our church hoping to open for public worship, hopefully in September, I'll be giving our organ tuner a tinkle and asking Paul to come and give the organ a once over. So hopefully in a couple of weeks' time, it'll be sounding even better once Paul has worked his magic. Thank you for tuning in. Stay safe and keep well, and we'll see you next week for episode 70.